Hey guys, I'm back, and in the last part we pretty much completed the way Musou Mode. Now we're gonna go and do it again, but this time we're gonna unlock the Way Tales, as well as making sure the final act is gonna be the Fall of Wu instead of the Fall of Shu. So with all that said, here we go. I mean, we're doing the same thing just like we did in the Shu Musou Mode, but now, you know, obviously we're gonna do it the Way Musou Mode. And speaking of the Way Musou Mode, for the fact that we completed the Way Musou Mode, we unlocked Yuan Shao's Musou Mode. So, yeah, I'm not going to worry about that now. I'll worry about that later. But for now, we're going to go and play the Way Musou Mode again. And unlike the Shu Musou Mode, where I actually had to unlock a character and a tail, I don't have to worry about that here. So, with all that said, I'm going to start this Musou Mode playing as Dian Wei. So, yeah, let's do it.
With impunity. This isn't a new age. This is utter chaos.
But also, an interesting opportunity for you, cousin.
Indeed, chaos can be a powerful ally.
First, I shall quell this rebellion, so my name shall be feared. Army, forward!
The Han Dynasty, long the center of power, suffers from internal strife and corruption. In response to this oppression, numerous uprisings begin to surface across the land. Led by their leader Zhang Jiao, the followers of the religious sect known as the Way of Peace rise up in protest to the corruption besieging the land. This revolt came to be known as the Yellow Turban Rebellion, due to the yellow scarves worn around the heads of Zhang's followers. In response to this dire situation, the Imperial Court sends out a call to arms across the land, raising an army under the command of General He Jin to combat the Yellow Turban threat. Amongst these brave warriors gathered from across the land, the face of the talented and ambitious Cao Cao can be seen. Alright, so, first things first, we're going to unlock the first tale, The Return of the Yellow Turbans, and it's pretty much the same exact thing if I recall, from what we did in the Shu Musou Mode. But getting it is different, unlike the Shu Musou Mode. In the Shu Musou Mode, we had to play the Yellow Turban Rebellion. That's it. Here, we have to play the Yellow Turban Fortress first, and then play the Yellow Turban Rebellion and make sure Zhang Jiao retreats in the stage. I think I remember saying something along the lines of playing the Yellow Turban Rebellion first and making sure Zhang Jiao retreats. But that's part of it. We have to play Yellow Turban Fortress first, from what I'm recalling. And, yeah. So with all that said, let's start. And I was going to say change characters, but this is the first part. So anyway, we're going to go the equipment, the weapon. We have a hand axe at level 2. I'm hoping to Now, actually, I don't even think I'm going to get to level 3 in this part. Part of me thinks I should just change characters. But, you know what? Screw it. Anyway, items are the same. I'm not worrying about it as much. The bodyguards. I use KOE for the Way Musou Mode. So, yeah, we'll do it again. Objectives. Same thing, we have to defeat Zhang Bao to win. If Zhu Jun's defeated, if I die, or if we run out of time, we lose, it's a game over. Plain and simple, the unit info. For the Han forces, we have Zhu Jun. Cao Cao with Zhang Liao, Zhao Houdun, and Dian Wei. Sun Jian with Sun Shengxiang and Huang Gai. And Liu Bei with Wei Yan and Jiang Wei. Jeez. Anyway, for the Yellow Turbans, you have Zhang Bao, Cheng Yuanji, Zhou Kong, Pei Yuan Shao, Bo Zhang, and He Yi. Why do I think there was an officer here? No. Alright, well, if anyone knows the history of the Romance of the Three Kingdoms and biographies, you might understand why I crack up about this. But anyway, yeah. So anyway, let's do it.
Cao Cao will advance from the east and Sun Jian from the west. The volunteer forces may move as they like.
Alright, so we're gonna do the same thing. Maybe I... Which part was it where I actually, I think I might have done it here in the Wei Musou mode, but, there was a time where we actually prevented the, Phantom, thing. So, I'll trigger it this time. I think that was by sheer accident that I didn't, you know, trigger it, but anyway. Alright, we secured that gate. I don't know why I'm going for gates. But anyway, here's He Yi.
Who's next? We must not fall behind.
And now I'm just gonna say screw it and go to the other side and start that off first. And, I don't know why I'm in the mood for taking down gate captains. But, I'm just going to. Because I'm bored, and I have nothing else better to do. So, there we go. Yeah. So, now we'll go and defeat Bo Zhang. Yeah, Bo Zhang. And I think what I did in the last, well, the last time I played this stage anyway, and I think it was just Musou mode in general. What I did was I went from behind and secured that gate, opened the gate up, and pretty much entered that little... Well, I didn't even enter it. Zhou Kong actually went after me. And we weren't even inside this fortress here. Not fortress, but inside the fort. And that really didn't trigger the Phantom cutscene. Well, let alone the Phantoms. So... that might be the reason why you didn't see it in that one part. And I just triggered that by accident. So, I mean, I pull that off by accident. So, it's amazing what kind of shit you can learn in this game. Despite the fact that, you know, you played it for 10 years. And with that, obviously,
there is a way to stop these winds. Keep advancing.
You could do two things. One, you could actually go around, defeat Zhou Kong and the Phantom troops, and then defeat Pei Yuan Shao from there. Two, you could keep advancing and just go around it. And three, which is something I discovered just, you know, recently, is that you can actually destroy those windmills and then you're set. But anyway, we're gonna go and defeat Zhou Kong now and try to avoid these Phantom units.
What's going on? What? Get away from me!
Because we can't kill them, but they could kill us.
Behind every spell, there is always some demon.
And Zhou Kong is down.
Alright, who's next?
And let's make sure... oh shit.
We must not fall behind.
Let's make sure we break these cauldrons because I cannot afford getting killed. I mean, I don't think I'm going to get killed in this stage because it's the first act, but, you know, I've seen crazy shit happen. I mean, I came over it on the Yellow Turban Rebellion with a friend, cousin, because we weren't knowing what the hell we were doing. And I hate to say it, but I feel like that Yellow Turban Rebellion stage is the hardest one amongst all of them. Not this game, Dynasty Warriors 3, if anyone's wondering. Just for the fact that you have Zhang Mengcheng appearing as reinforcements, and for some bizarre reason, he's overpowered and kills Cao Cao within seconds. I mean, I talked about that a lot. I keep on, you know, if you want to say bashing or whatever it may be, but it's just something that's completely out of the ordinary.
Impressive.
Because it doesn't happen in any other particular Dynasty Warriors game. It's just that game. But, yeah. Anyway, so, well, I totally forgot to grab the dim sum. I think I grabbed it. Did I? I'll go check it out. I remember grabbing, I remember attacking the cauldron, and that was it. Oh, there it is. So yeah, this is the first part of two things that we have to do to unlock the tale, the return of the Yellow Turbans. And like I said, I think it's the same exact thing as the one that we did for the Shoot Musou mode. The only difference, like I said, Shoot Musou mode, all you have to do is play the Yellow Turban Rebellion, make sure you play it first, and that's it. Here, you have to play the Yellow Turban Fortress, then play the Yellow Turban Rebellion, and make sure Zhang Jiao retreats. And then after Act 2, it will occur. So, after we complete the Yellow Turban Rebellion, it won't happen until we complete Act 2. Which can be a little bit frightening in a way, for the fact that, you know, if you mess it up, you won't know until you pretty much complete Act 2. And at that point, you just wasted your fucking time, and then you have to do it all over again. That is if you fucked up. But anyway, so we defeated Pei Yuan Shao. Now, for the fact that we're back here, we're gonna destroy the windmills. Maybe attacking by foot will make it easier. No, there's no difference. Alright, there you go. And, yeah, so now we're gonna go and defeat, Cheng Guangji, and then defeat Zhang Bao. And for anyone that's wondering, I mean, I said it before in the very, very, very beginning of my Let's Perfect, and I'll say it here again, just to, you know, keep you updated, or anyone that's watching this video for the first time, this being the first video that they're watching. The commanders could actually retreat, like I said before, in order to unlock the tails. One particular tail here. So, what you have to do for that is, well, in this stage anyway, you have to defeat every general and then secure the back gate by Zhang Bao. After you secure that gate, he'll start to retreat. And if he retreats, he will be in the Yellow Turban Rebellion. If you defeat him here, he will not appear at the Yellow Turban Rebellion. And in this case, he will cause the fire geysers in the Yellow Turban Rebellion. I'm not that concerned about it regardless, but I do want to show off having one Zhang brother on there and the other one not. And I think if one of them's there, Zhang Jiao won't do the boulder magic at the end. I mean, I could be wrong on that, but if I'm wrong, then someone could correct me, but... Well, I mean, at the end of the day, in the next part, I'll be corrected or stand corrected or whatever it may be. So, now, well, let me get 100 KOs, just because I've been lacking in the KO department. I don't know why, it just feels like it's much easier getting KOs in Dynasty Warriors 3. I could be totally wrong on that, but... Maybe for the fact that I'm used to playing Dynasty Warriors 3, and for the fact that I'm used to playing Yellow Turban Rebellion, the Battle Hulao Gate, and I'm playing the Battle Hulao Gate, and I'm typically getting 500, 600, 700 KOs, sometimes 1,000, you know, that might be part of it. But anyway, with all I said, since we have the Battle Axe activated for 30 seconds, let's try to defeat Zhang Bao before that time is up. And...
Alright, who's next?
It wasn't meant to be.
And that's a win. Alright, so... That felt like it was pretty quick. It only took us... Oh, wow. 9 minutes and 48 seconds. A lot longer than I thought I was going to complete it in. I thought it was going to be 5 minutes, but... You know, that's fine by me. Anyway, items-wise, I'm not really concerned because it's going to be hard to top what I have at the moment. Unless I actually farm for it to battle Wuzhang Plains. I did say I was gonna show off the items there. The next time I play to battle Wuzhang Plains, I'm gonna try to show that off. And, it's pretty much the same spiel when it comes to items. I'm not gonna really make a bonus video on how to grind for items here. Because there's many ways you could do it, but I feel like doing that particular way, playing the battle Wuzhang Plains, doesn't matter which side I believe. Grabbing those 5 item boxes, doing the same thing as I did with the Battle of Yoteng or Shiteng, whatever you want to call it, in Dynasty Warriors 3. Same thing, you know, pretty much defeat everybody or, you know, feel be at a comfortable position. And then save, grab the items, defeat the commander. If it's not the items that you want, then start select, you know, load up the interim save that you had. And do it, you know, rinse and repeat until you get the items that you want. But, yeah. Anyway, our KO count's 106. We got 56 points because of it. Our worthy opponent count is 6. We defeated everybody in the stage. Yeah. So, we got a good 2,800 points. Well, 2,876 points. I doubt we're gonna get much from it, though. We should rank 13, probably, but that's it. And weapon experience, I doubt we're getting anything from it. No. Like I said, I should just play as a character that I know that has like a higher level. That way I don't have to worry about wasting my time. And, you know, now I probably have to play with Dian Wei later on. But, you know, at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter. I'm going to have all the characters' weapons at level 9 in one way, shape, or form because I have to get the level 10 and level 11 weapons. So... Anyway, we're gonna go and save, and I still have this save here, believe it or not. Anyway, I'm gonna overwrite this one, and then, yeah, there you have it. You've been watching my gaming adventures, and I'll see you in the next part. We'll take on the battle, well, not the battle, but the Yellow Turban Rebellion, and, complete that second part by having Zhang Jiao retreating. And then we'll be set for that particular tale. So, peace out.